أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. كذب الصمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها. صدق الله العظيم. One thing I told you before is that from سورة المزمل till the end of the Quran, all these surahs are in perfect pairs. But at some places you will find two pairs can be grouped together to make a subgroup. And this is the first example. Surah Al-Shams and Surah Al-Layl, they are a pair. Surah Al-Duha and Surah Al-Inshirah, they are a pair. But all four of them go to make a subgroup. There is one subject which develops gradually in these four surahs. I told you that in Surah Al-Shams there are 8 ayat of oath, but the reality or the statement on which these oaths have been taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها. Now that statement comes, قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها. Verily, the one who purifies his soul is successful. And the one who buries it in dust is unsuccessful. Now, we have been translating this tazkiyah by the word purification. Actually, it's very hard to translate many fundamental terms of Quran into some one word of English language. It's very difficult. Tazkiyah doesn't mean only purification. It means purifying something in order that it should develop. This word, you know, is applied by the Arabs, Bedouin Arabs, to the function of a gardener. When he enters his garden, some of the plants he has himself sowed, either for flowers or for fruit. But around those plants he finds grass has grown up, other unwanted vegetation is there. So what's the result? Whatever is the nourishment in the soil is now shared by this also. It's not all going to the plant which you have sown. In the same way, the oxygen from the air that is also being shared. So he removes all these things. This is called tazkiyah, because they are hampering the growth of that plant which he has sown in order that it should grow up, be mature, bear either fruits or flowers. So man actually is a plant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has planted it. And he wants to see it flourishing, growing. But what type of growth? Not the growth of an animal. His growth as vice-student of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who reflects the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his personality. So this process to remove all the hindrances in the way of the spiritual development of a human being, it is tazkiyah. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Only that one is successful who has really purified his soul, developed his soul, his ana, his khudi. Which Allama Iqbal calls tamir khudi, construction of yourself. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. And I told you, دَسَّا يَدُسُّو, in Arabic means to bury something in the sand. This, you know, came in Quran for those Arab Bedouins who used to bury their female childs, daughters, alive. هَمْ يَدُسُّهُ فِي التُّرَاب. He kept on thinking, should I keep him, keep her with me, despite this humiliation, or I should bury her. So, دَسَّا يَدُسُّو. This is it. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. If you can't take care of that real self of yours, you are only taking care of the animal self of yours, the animal aspect of your existence, then this animal existence of yours becomes like a grave in which that spirit is buried. Only this grave is mobile, it is moving. It's not fixed at one place. But every human being then becomes a mobile grave of his real spiritual identity and self. Now this regards mainly personal and individual purification and development of the ego or development of the self. But now we come to the collective level, human society. This also behaves in the same way. If there is no arrangement of a purification of that society and that nation, that people, that community, it is doomed. So a process has to continue, which we call Amr bil Ma'ruf Nahi anil Munkar. At the collective level, this enjoining upon people whatever is good and forbidding them from whatever is wrong, it is actually the purification of the society. This process has to continue if this society is to live as a healthy society. If this process comes down, then the society is doomed, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends a devastating chastisement, and they are finished. So one example.